Good morning, everyone. My name is Simone Ciccolella, and in this talk, I'm going to present you this paper called Triplet-Based Similarity Score for Fully Multilabel Trees with Polyocurrent Labels. The main goal of this topic is to understand how to compare phylogeny. In particular, we are interested in this type of phylogeny, which is called the fully multilabel trees with potentially polyocurrent label, because this type of phylogeny is what the current cancer progression inference method are producing at the moment. There exist a few measures for this topic, which are the MLTED from 2019 and the DISC-NCASET from 2020. In particular, our measure is based on the classical triplet distance based on classical phylogeny. In particular, a classical phylogeny is a binary tree where only the leaves are labeled. And there exists multiple interpretations of this distance, but the main concept is that the distance is based on how many triplets are or not conserved between the two trees. Our measure takes inspiration from the classical triplet distance, and it generalizes it on more complex type of phylogenies. If we want to apply the triplet-based distance on a fully labeled trees, we first have to introduce the main structure, which is the minimal tree topology. A minimal tree topology is defined for a triple of labels. In this particular case, suppose we want to find the minimal tree topology for the triplet EHK, we have to construct a subtree, which is composed as a set of vertices that are the tree labels and the lowest common ancestor of each pair of these labels. Then we construct all nodes with degree 2 that are not in this set of vertices. In particular, the minimal tree topology for the triplet EHK is the one shown here. Following this particular definition, we are able to enumerate all the possible minimal tree topology for a set of labels. And these are the topology, of course, with the additional possible permutation of all the labels. Now, let's have a look at the multilabel trees. So, multilabel trees are trees where each node can have more than one label. These are the most common type of cancer trees available. The idea of the minimal tree topology here is very similar. The only difference is that it is possible that one or more labels of the triple are actually in the same node. So, for example, in this case, we want to find the minimal tree topology for the triple EMK. In this case, E and M are in the same node. The concept of building the minimal tree topology is the same as before, and this is the topology. Following this other formulation, we have additional minimal tree topology, once again with all the possible permutations of the labels. The importance of the enumeration is given by the fact that since we know that these are all the possible minimal tree topologies, we are able to fully characterize them as a function of the LCA of the pairs of the given triplet of labels. Let's now have a look at yet another generalization on the phylogeny. In this case, these are the polyoccurring labels. A polyoccurring labels may be present in a cancer tree, and they could be due to a recurrent mutation or multiple losses of the same mutation. In this particular case, the difference is that now we have one minimal tree topology for each occurrence of the labels. In this case, for the triple EMK, E is appearing twice, so we have two different minimal tree topologies. In particular, we define the multiset M of a triplet ABC as the multiset union of all the possible minimal tree topology for all the possible occurrences of the labels A, B, and C. Lastly, to define our measure, the MP3-tree similarity measure, we need two additional variables. The variable n for the triple ABC, which is the cardinality of the multiset intersection of all the different multisets m for the labels ABC in the first tree and in the second tree. So this is basically the number of shared minimal tree topologies within the two trees. And D for the triple ABC is the maximum cardinality of the two multiset M. So basically the MP3 tree similarity measure is the number of shared minimal tree topology over the total number of possible tree topologies between two trees. Of course, the two sets of labels on the tree may not be equal. For this reason, we defined two alternatives of the MP3 measure. One is called MP3 intersection, where the computation is the same, but it is done on the intersection of the labels between the two trees, and the union, where once again the computation is the same, but it is done over the union of the set of labels of the two trees. However, our main goal was to define one single measure that could provide insightful information about two phylogenies. In particular, if we have a look here, we see that the intersection measure, the MP3 intersection, is able to capture more the similarity within the same group, but it tends to have more noise. On the other hand, the MP3 union function discriminates more between groups, but has a lower resolution within the same group. How can we combine them? The main idea here is that where the two trees are very similar or very dissimilar, the two measures tend to agree. The most interesting part of the problem is when two trees are not quite similar, but not quite dissimilar. Our main idea is to use a sigmoid function to push these middle values into the closest extreme. What we do is that we define a final MP3 measure called MP3 sigma, which is a combination of the union and the intersection weighted by this sigmoid function. As a result, we have one single measure that is able to capture the best out of the two previous measures. So in particular, this MP3 sigma is able to distinguish between groups as well as the union function, and also to characterize more intergroup similarity as well as the intersection. So let's have a look with the comparison of the previous mentioned measures, which are CASET, DISC, and MLTET. CASET and DISC both have distinction between intersection and union. We can see that MP3 is the measure that is able to fully divide between inter and intragroup. So these are on the diagonal five different type of group phylogenies. To better visualize the previous concept, we can have a look at the distribution of intrasimilarity and intersimilarities of this cluster. Here, the most important part is not how high or low these values are, but actually how distinct the two distributions are. And in particular, here we can see that the intersimilarity distribution of MP3 is the most compact one, so it doesn't matter that it is the lowest scoring on the similarity scale, but since the intersimilarity is far outside of the intrasimilarity distribution, it is able to distinguish very well between the two. Of course, the measure can be applied on clustering, and in particular here we can see a very interesting type of simulation where we have five different trees where two of them are subtype of the other. So what we want to achieve here is three main clusters and two of them splitted into smallest cluster. And we can see here that MP3 and also this view tend to do a very good job at this type of clustering. Let's look at the most interesting part, which is the application on real data. In particular, here we have three phylogenies of renal cell carcinoma, and we have the reference provided by the sequencing paper, and the three is inferred by Leechy and MIPAP, which are two very well-known cancer progression inference tools from bulk sequencing data. We can see here that all the measures tend to agree with them, with the exception of possibly cassette union. They tend to say that these three are actually fairly similar. Let's now have a look at this data from breast cancer. Once again, we have the reference and the Leechy and MIPAP trees. Even from this graphical view, we can see that these three trees are not very similar. In particular, they are not similar nor labeling, neither by topology. And in fact, we expect to have a lower similarity between the reference and Leechy and MIPAP. And we can see this in particular in MP3 and cassette measure, and also to some extent the MLTAD measure. However, disk measure tend to give a high similarity score. In this particular example, we see a high discrepancy in these measures, even if those three really seem very different. To further investigate these, we created an edge case. So in this particular case, we took all the 158 mutations from the MIPAP tree and placed them all in one single node. And we compare this edge case with the reference. And we see here that MP3 is the only measure that is actually able to find an expected very low similarity measure between those trees, because they are completely different, both topologically and label-wise. So this might be a case which is accentuated in the edge case, but is still very present on the real data, where MP3 is the only measure that is sensible enough to capture all these different nuances on the trees. So, as a conclusion, MP3 is the first measure to handle polyoccurring labels. It is very sensible to changes in both labeling and topologies. It is effective on both synthetic and real dataset. And it is applicable to clustering of various types of trees. I would like to conclude by acknowledging and thanking Iman Ajirasula, Victoria Popic, and Mare Patterson for the many interesting and illuminating discussion on cancer progression and phylogenies. I would also like to thank my co-authors from Algolab and the Horizon 2020 Research and Innovation Program, which supported this work. A preprint for this work is available on BioArchive, and the implementation is open source and available on GitHub and can easily be installed via PIP and Bioconda. Thank you very much for your attention.